What's up, everybody? This is Aura Elevini with Fully Deconverted, and I want to take this time to wish you, yes, a happy holidays, a Merry Christmas, whatever it is. I'm not afraid to say any of those terms, and I hope you're not afraid to hear them. But I do want to address one thing. As we're entering into our holiday season, I want to be very clear on one thing. There is no such thing as giving to God. That's simply not a thing. It's a figure of speech we use when we say, hey, I gave money to the church, I gave a tithe, I gave an offering, or when the pastor asks for it, hey, now is our time that where we return the tithe and our offerings and give that back to God, because after all, God gives us everything, right? And we're just asked to return something. But that simply isn't true. It's a figure of speech that is largely misleading, because we all know that the money that we get is the money that we've earned by our employers or other clients that we provide services for. So next time your pastor says you're giving money back to God, the simple answer or response or thought that if you take 5 seconds, you'll know, is that, wait a minute, there's no supernatural influx of currency into our money market from a divine source. That simply doesn't happen. In fact, it's all man-made. In fact, all the services done are by humans. All the clients and all the service requests, the products offered, everything, all of this is in a closed system, and that closed system is the human economy. Nothing ever comes into it or exits out of it without our say-so. So the next time you are promised a divine reward for giving your tithes or offerings, think twice. Because this is just a way that churches really kind of put it out there, so that they can receive their funding, which there's nothing wrong with that, all right? All businesses have to do this, and I've crowdfunded projects before. I understand this. But under the auspice of a divine reward, which we receive a few promises for in the Bible, some seeming very temporal, some seeming everlasting, if these aren't measurable, and if the Christian community isn't disproportionately wealthy in some regard, then ought we to take this opportunity for a pause right now and admit to ourselves it simply isn't true.